In this video, we are going to use this VL53L0X laser distance meter to display the distance on the LCD1602 with I2C module with just four wires. Also, we'll see how we can use it with this larger screen. This is the wiring diagram for VL53L0X. Because we needed two I2C connection and also 5 volts for this module for the LCD and 5 volts for the laser sensor, I've used pin 13 for extra VCC for this. In Arduino, we have I2C pins, SCL and SDA here, and A4 and A5 also can be used, as I've explained before. So without any breadboard, we can use it like this. VCC have been connected using green wire to pin 13. In the code, we have defined this pin as extra VCC pin. Second pin, ground, have been connected using blue wire to ground in here. SCL or clock is connected using a brown wire with that to the last pin. This is SCL labeled inside it. And SDA have been connected using a gray wire to the SDA. For the LCD, from the top we see ground have been connected using black wire to the ground, and then VCC have been connected using white wire to 5 volts, and then SDA using a gray wire to A4. SCL or clock have been connected using a purple wire to A5. If you're using a blue module, the laser sensor with this color or with this color, all the locations are the same. And also with the black, pay attention to this diode, the red diode. It should be on this side because the label is on the other side. And here is the wiring for this VL53L0X on actual Arduino. It has been labeled from here. VCC is connected using green to pin 13. And the second pin, ground, is connected using blue wire to the ground of Arduino. And then we have a purple wire is connected to SCL, as it has been connected also to SCL or of Arduino. And the last pin is SDA, have been connected using gray wire to the SDA of Arduino. If you're using this type of Arduino module, the SDA and SCL have been labeled here, not on the pin header. And for the LCD1602 with I2C module, SCL have been connected using this pink wire to A5. SDA has been connected using gray wire to A4. And VCC have been connected using white wire to 5 volts. And the ground have been connected using black wire to ground of Arduino. Now, this is I2C scanner. Let's run it and see the I2C address for this laser sensor and for the display. And as you can see, it shows 020X29. That 29 is the address for the VL53L0X, and 3FS for my module. And here, if I connect my other module, it shows 26. So this is 26. Let me now explain the code. This is exactly the same as a previous lecture, which I've explained it. The only new thing is this one, VCC2. We have defined pin 13 as VCC for this module. This liquid crystal _I2C is a library that we have studied in previous lesson. You have to download and include it. When you download it, it will be a zip file and then include it. Then we create an instance of this class. We call it LCD. We pass the I2C address for the LCD, 16 character and 2 line. We have to pass this. And this is a constant integer type. We call it type, and 1 if you want to display in millimeter, and 2 if you want to display centimeter. Inside the setup, we initialize the serial monitor. We set the VCC as an output using the pin mode command. Now this pin is pin 13 is an output, and then using digital write, we set the same pin high. So this gives us 5 volts for the module. We say LCD.begin, initializing the LCD, and also we're setting the backlight, and the setup is done. Inside the loop, sensor.read range continuous millimeter. This is long function name. This up to this point, it will read the distance in millimeter, and we store it in a variable called distance. And then we print this text on the screen. Clear the LCD because this is a loop and LCD has to be cleared from previous value. We print this text on the screen. This is the text that you're reading. And then we set the cursor 0 line 1. So it goes cursor 0 line 1. That was line 0. Now we are here. And we print DIST with a dot with this colon. And after that, after 7 characters, we set the cursor at the 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It starts from here. And we check if the type is 2, then we convert the distance. How we do it to centimeter, we get a distance divided by 10. And then we make it float, because when you convert from millimeter to centimeter, the portion that is shown as millimeter should be as a decimal point. So we converted the integer to float, and the result of this will be stored here. We call it distance cm, centimeter of type float. And then we print the same value that is there. We print the distance. After that, we print centimeter or millimeter beside it. This is for the serial monitor that prints the value for us continuously. The same value that you read here is displayed in here as well. Else means if the type is not 2, then we need it in millimeter. We print the distance, we print this mm at the end. Pay attention here, we did not set the cursor. Without the cursor, as soon as you have space, it will just work fine. After that, we print this on the screen with millimeter instead of centimeter. And this is part of the debugging system. If the timeout happens, it will print this, leave it. It will help you to understand, and then this will print a new line, and 500 milliseconds is the blink that you see. Every half a second it reads the data. And here is a demonstration. As you can see, it shows some distance here because in front of this ruler we have nothing. And let me put it directly at 0, and let me put this this box here at 140 millimeter. And it shows around 4 millimeter deviation. Let me go to 10. This shows 96 millimeter. And now I am at 60, 30. It shows very exact. Wow. And I'm now pointing it to the wall. 110 centimeter, about a meter. And if I go further, and if I point it to the ceiling, which is far away, slowly, you can see that it shows 8190. When you see this, it shows that it is out of range. It cannot measure more than 1.2 meter in continuous measurement. And now I'm inserting the other module. Just pay attention for the VCC. When I insert it, you will see that you read minus 1 mm. For that reason, just reset this. Press the reset on your Arduino, and you will see that it will get fixed. Because when you connect it, you have to give it a little time. Now at 90 millimeter, it shows 94. And one thing that I noticed that this reflective surface, if I point it to this, you will get incorrect, very incorrect value. For example, I'm putting it now at 10. This is 100 millimeter. As you can see, it shows 88 or 80. It's a huge difference. As I put the other edge, you will see that it shows very accurate. And let me just point it towards the ruler. That's 11 centimeter. And the same way this black module works without any change in wiring. The only thing you need is to reset. I just reset this. So it's 100 millimeter. And the same code also will work with this larger screen 2004. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this VL53L0X module to display the distance on LCD1602 display.